you all heard our word we fellowship this morning, we all heard many of the riches in the ministry are in Chinese at the moment, especially those materials for children. And praise the Lord, there are some faithful saints, they are laboring on it, but limited by the human resource, we can only do this much. That's why we call that more saints can participate. And then thank the Lord that you all signed up for this. And later on, the sisters will give you a workshop, tell you the burden, the testimony, and then how to do it. Some hands-on experience. Yeah. Thank the Lord for your signing up for this workshop. Amen. Yeah, you all have a handout with you while you are still eating. Maybe we can spend some time going through this excerpt. It is about learning to serve with the publications. Before that, maybe I can share a little bit about why publication is so important and translation work is so important. You know, my wife is from Vietnam, and before 1996, they were not in a recovery. I mean, all the churches in Vietnam are not in a recovery, but they, because of their entering into two books. The first book is called The Orthodoxy of the Church and the Normal Christian Life. And you know why? Because some Vietnamese translated these two books into Vietnamese. And they spread among all the Vietnamese. And the more I was touched is during our family's past trip to Vietnam. We visit a place where some older saints share with us. You know, they don't have copy machine. They use their hand to copy it. So you know publication. And because of that, a lot of saints got this book, and they enter into it. They rise up. They 他们从工会里面就出来了。 They came out of the denomination. And then eventually when they get in touch with the saints in a recovery, yeah, they fully enter into the recovery. So saints, publication is really important, and translate. It relies a lot on the translation work. Amen. Yeah. So how about we spend some time, enter into, read one or two sentences? How about that? Let's read the title together. Learning to Serve with the Publication. The Value of Publication Work. 1. Having long-lasting, widespread effects.
There will be a great lack and even a great loss in the Lord's work in the Gospel and in the truth if it's not done in coordination with the publication work. It would have been very difficult for the ministry of Brother Nee to spread without the publication work. The usefulness of the publications is long-lasting and widespread. Like water, the publications can spread widely and imperceptibly seep into people. A published message can have a great effect simply by flowing into a home and reaching someone whom we do not know. The effect of the publications lasts forever and is not as shallow as the effect of only hearing a message. A person may be touched as he listens to a message, but after 3 days, his feeling may wane and he may forget it. However, the more a person reads the messages, the more he will understand. And the messages will stay in his memory a longer time and give him a deeper impression. Psychologists have discovered that television is more powerful and is a strong impact than radio because visual memory lasts longer than auditory memory. Thus, the value of the publications lies in the fact that their effect is long-lasting and widespread. The Bible has been among human beings for a few thousand years, and its effect is self-evident. Learning in the publication work. Among the brothers and sisters in the book room, some transcribe, some edit, and some proofread. I feel that these areas of labor are greatly beneficial to the serving ones. If we would be diligent to learn the matters of transcribing and proofreading, there would be a healthy future for the publication work in 3 to 5 years. In the publication work, there must be patience and a willingness to bury ourselves in it and work hard. The more we persevere, the more proficient we will become. We must grasp every opportunity to learn how to write and to learn the truth. Even if we are simply transcribing, proofreading, cutting, pasting, or designing covers, there are many things that we can learn. Learning is very beneficial to the development of our function. There are many who are now serving in the book room, and I'm very happy about this. I hope that 3 to 5 years from now, you would all become useful persons who can co-labor in the move of the churches. For example, we are now promoting the gospel work on the campuses, in the homes, with children, and in the communities. These are 4 great areas that need the coordination of the publications in matters such as writing gospel tracts and producing a children's hymnal. Our present children's hymnal is not very good. Sometimes I see a lack, but I do not want to say anything for fear of discouraging you. In order to meet the need, sometimes it is all right to be accommodating and to simply accept what is usable. In any case, we should not be discouraged or afraid that we will not do a good job. Everything that is successful must have a beginning. All things require action, and the more we do something, the more we will make progress. We should not be afraid of moving slowly. We should only be afraid of standing still. We need to be exercised in many different areas. We cannot be lazy. I would advise you not to do things according to wild imaginations. Rather, be diligent and practical. Whenever you do something, begin in a small way. Do not set your heart on doing great things. Moreover, do not try to do too much or go too fast. Do not write something today and submit it for printing tomorrow. This is callous. You must revise it again and again. There is a good saying, slow work means careful work. The vision of the publication work. Since the effect of the publication work is long-lasting and widespread, it is entirely worthwhile to spend time and effort on it. In addition, you must be patient. Every aspect of the publication work, whether writing, editing, proofreading, or transcribing, is very tedious. If you do it for a long time, you easily become frustrated. Therefore, you must exercise to have the endurance to concentrate on your labor. For the past 11 years, I've spent about 100 days every half a year working on the outlines and footnotes for the recovery version. I spend at least 4 or 5 hours a day at my desk, absorbed in work, and allow my wife to take care of everything else in my living. If I had not done this, I would never have been able to complete the footnotes or the life studies of the entire New Testament. If you want to finish something, especially in the publication work, you cannot rely only on regular work hours. According to common practice, the hours here at the book room are from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. After you leave the office, you still need to care for your family and for the church life. However, If you do the publication work only during regular work hours, you will not accomplish much in a week. Perhaps some of you can write quite well, but you must not become proud and think that you can create something original and that you can finish a poem in just 7 steps. I do not believe that anyone has such a natural talent. Therefore, you should not be satisfied with yourselves. You must spend time to labor. Everything that I write must go through several periods of consideration, or it will not be good. Improvement in the matter of writing is always possible. Therefore, you should not think that you know how to write. This is never the case. Moreover, since the ministry of the word that the Lord has given to us is like water that flows out unceasingly and continually advances, we must keep up and not be satisfied with our present condition. The greatest lack in our publication work is that we do not have high enough literary standard. Therefore, I will never get tired of exhorting you to learn. I hope that you would do your best to learn, especially in the matter of editing, and that in 3 to 5 years, we could improve our literary capacity. In the Lord's full-time service, the publication work is the top area because the publications are long-lasting and widespread, able to touch people and convey a deep impression. These are things that other areas of the work cannot replace. In conclusion, the publication work requires vision, patience, and perseverance. Sometimes when we are considering the right words and phrases, we should put down our pens and walk outside to call on the Lord or sing a few verses of a hymn to relax our heart and increase the feeling in our spirit. Then, when we return to writing, we'll be able to express things well. This word is from my experience, and I hope that it will be an encouragement and help to the young ones.
In the translation of the children materials from Chinese to English, in total, I assisted in the translation of about 5 lessons. So it was a new experience for me, as I have never meddled in any translation-related work before. I enjoyed the whole process, even though it can be frustrating at times when I struggle to form the sentence that will accurately capture the full meaning intended in its Chinese form. So what sparked my interest in being involved in the translation work is due to the fascination with how certain saints, they are always able to translate on the spot the messages and testimonies shared during the combined Lord's Table meeting like this morning. Also, I've always been intrigued by the translation of the Bible, the hymns that we sing, and the Holy Word for Morning revival messages that we pursue weekly into Chinese, since I normally attend the Lord's Table meeting in an English district. So how I have benefited from this experience is that, firstly, it exposed me to reading the Bible and even the footnotes in Chinese, something that is very new and refreshing to me. Secondly, it has allowed me to have a new appreciation for the Word of God in Chinese, my mother tongue language. And lastly, I get to revise and recap on the lessons covered in the children's material that are very crucial in understanding the book of Genesis in the Bible. And it's okay if your language ability is not equally strong in both English and Chinese, because it forces you to have fellowship with the saints that are serving to and seek their help. So for those that are interested in translation, but are not sure whether they are up for it or not, I strongly encourage you to just sign up and give it a shot. Amen.
Very encouraging to hear a testimony like that, and it just brings back memories of how long ago when I started to do some translation. It's not because I could do it, I felt like I couldn't, it was more like a need. And when I had my own children, and I was exposed to a lot of materials from Taiwan, wow, they were so rich. But then within the district, there were some saints who couldn't read the Chinese materials. And there was that need. I mean, urgently, there was that need. So, okay, translate in whatever knowledge I had. And it wasn't very good. That's when I realized it was a lack. And I needed, I wish there was some kind of training, but there wasn't any kind of training. And it's just, you know, just feel your way through, and then when you make mistakes, you just learn trial and error, right? I still remember, you know, the book 造就的故事. I didn't know how to translate that, stories that build. That was so funny. What a title, stories that build. Then I realized, oh, 造就 in English is actually edify. So then after the first book of translation, there were stories that built. Then the second book, I put stories that edify. So it was like, you know, as I learned, I learned the better ways, a better way of translation. So I'm glad we have this kind of a little workshop and such a fellowship. I think we are in a bilingual country. It's much needed to be able to be fluent in both languages and worldwide as well. So it's a skill. It's needed anywhere we go, because you may be called upon to make translation. And especially in the Lord's Recovery, there are certain terms that we use. Like I just mentioned to you, 造就, if you literally go Google, they'll give you all kinds of words. But in our midst, we use the word edify. Right, so then sometimes, like Darwin was saying, Brother Darwin was saying, you know, when you listen to a translation on the stage by certain saints, wow, they are so quick in doing it. And I remember there was a brother who once fellowshiped. He was in the literature, doing the literature. He said, the more exposure you have, the faster you are at getting it and being able to, you know, code switch, you know, the language. Okay, so my part is just to let you know that so far, in our midst, the children's materials, we have been doing some translation for this set of materials. There are 12 books, actually, and it starts with When I Was a Little Baby. It's been very good. It's been many, many years. I forgot to check how long ago already, but as long as when my kids were small. So now we come to Titus Baby. And then who knows when y'all grow up and then you have get married and Zhou Jin's, you know, and your baby, and then there will be the next generation and next generation. And we still feel this set is very well packaged for the youngest all the way to P6, 12 years old. So the 12 books has been around for a while, and we still feel it's good. So some of them have been translated already, but we want to revise. And like I did share with you my example, some words that we used were not correct, and we found out later, and then so we need to revise constantly. Okay? So this was a very first one. So some, like your little one and your little one, would be coming to this book. Okay? All right. Then the next book is The Fruit of the Holy Spirit. And here, actually, there are some testimonies and stories to do with, you know, the Bible verse, the fruit of the Spirit, you know, goodness and all that. So this book, and then the third book. And so it really grows, and this series really helps with our children to have the knowledge of the Bible, the characters in the Bible. And so now the beginning, God created. And you have God's creation, the 7 days. Every day there's in-depth kind of information on God's creation, appreciating God's creation. Actually, come to think of it, if you get into this, it's also good for gospel preaching. Okay, next one. The next one is God, man in God's creation, about man, talking about man. And the next one, about a bright little lamb. It's actually about relationship between man. So your relationship with parents, relationship with friends, different people, okay? And 10 commandments, all right? Understanding 10 commandments. And after that, God's calling in the Old Testament. And then you have all these 5 more volumes actually to be translated. So you realize those other volumes have been translated already. And then these ones, somewhere halfway here and there. So they need revision, they need to be... Oh, this actually got a little... Okay, all right. We had some brief notes on it, but nothing in depth. So these ones need translation. And these ones actually are more targeted to like P3, 4, 5, 6 age group. Okay? So it would be very valuable kind of resource for our children serving ones. Nima. Okay, so in short, this is what we're going to be doing. And then I'm going to pass on to Sister Zisan, who will actually guide us into some examples of translation.
What I'm going to share now is the learning that we learned from all the previous saints who help out in the translation and proofreading. So I'm just helped to consolidate and present to you all. Okay, the first one, the process of translation work. What are the process? The first, we have translation. So that's round one. When you have the Chinese book and you need to look at it and put it into English. That's round one. Round two. Round two means you already have the English translation, but you need to read what the translators did. And then you need to compare. Why do we need to compare? Because certain words may be missed out, certain context may not be, you know, may not be there. So we need to compare against the Chinese text to check for accuracy and also to check for grammatical or human errors. And the last stage, the very last stage is done by native speakers where they are really, really fluent in English. Their first language is English, or even they are very good in it, whereby they can right away spot, there's something off about this, so they need to edit. So they do not need to, compare against the Chinese original text. All they need to do is to make sure that there's a smooth read. Unless when you read it, you don't understand what it's trying to say, then we need to refer to the Chinese text. What exactly is it trying to say? Then you correct it according to the Chinese text. Okay? Okay so far? Amen. So I have I will teach you how to do round one. So round one, when we translate from Chinese text to English, so over here, there's a big pile of Chinese text, right? And then what's the first thing you need to do? What's the first thing we need to do? Because we don't want to use our own words, right? We need to use the words from the ministry. Yeah, there's one publication, one word, one ministry. So whatever we do, we need to refer to the Bible. And on top of the Bible, we need to refer to the ministry book references, which is happen to be here. So there's a reference, I'll say you need to refer to the life study, message 13. So I have a exercise for all of you, okay? Okay, are you ready for hands-on exercise? Okay, now I have this passage on the left. And then I say, the portion, the verse reference, you can find it from here. And if you cannot see clearly, is 2 Kings chapter 2, chapter 4, or chapter 6, 1 to 7. I want all of you to take out your Bible now, your electronic Bible. Can you, the first person who can tell me where I can find this corresponding portion will have a small gift from me. Okay? So, take out your Bible. Find this portion in that verse reference.
Because my mother tongue is Chinese, so just now I roughly, sorry about it, browse through this, I think it's chapter 2. Yeah, it's talking about this water, right? But I haven't find this yet. But I managed to find the water somewhere around there, yeah.
So what's your answer again, Brother Joseph? What's your
answer? 列王记下二章.
二章什么?几节?
几节啊? 二十一节.
Us, okay, there. Okay, thank you, brother. This is for you. Amen. So basically, how do we do it quickly? One very big clue is, 他已经还给我了. One very big clue is you look at the outline of your Holy Recovery Version. There's an outline, right? Yeah, in the outline, you have a bird's eye view of what's in there. And then you can zoom into the outline, chapter 2. Oh, it's talking about healing the dead water. Yeah, so healing the bad water of Jericho. So the outline helps a lot to find quickly. Okay, another thing. What if there are too many Bible references like boom, Nehemiah, chapter dun, all the way to chapter 13? You can't be like, oh, scroll. So there's a way to do it. Okay, first, if say for example the Chinese text is this Bible verse, and I want to find out where exactly this appears in the Bible, I look out for a keyword that is more unique to the verse. Like for example here, 城门被火焚烧. So I start one, I go to the Taiwan LSM website. And the Taiwan LSM website is this one. So you go to search the keyword, which is over here, 经文. You type 城门被火焚烧. Then all the verses with 城门被火焚烧 will come out. And then after that, you look out, oh, you look, 我祖先的坟墓. Actually, it appears the second one, Nehemiah 2:3. So this is a way to do a search with the help of the website and the search function. Ken? Amen. Okay. Next one. Other than Bible verse, you also need to look at ministry books. Ministry books at LSM online publication, some are not free anymore, but for life study it's free. So we can still access to it. So for example, I know that, oh, I go and search, oh, it's actually here in message 13. So I myself, I will skim through the entire message of chapter 13. Look out for, oh, that is the portion that talk about healing the backwater of Jericho. Then I will use the utterance in the life study instead of using my own language. So we can be faithful to the ministry. Okay, some pointers. When we send out the documents for your help to do up translation, we will always send you a template. And the template is important because it will help the saints at the back, the round tree saints. And another thing about template is that look at how this Bible reference is quoted in Chinese. Okay, can I ask, what does this mean? What is this chapter? What is this? So you can tell that Chinese is very obvious, right? Chapter is like that. Verse is like that. One is in character, one is in numeric. But how about English? Like boom, so complicated. So what is crucial here is the punctuation mark. For example, this one. With this semicolon, we know that it's a break to the next chapter. It is not chapter 31, verse 32. It is not. But it is Genesis chapter 32. So the semicolon is a break point for the next chapter. Whereas the comma is a continuation of the previous chapter. So if we get this wrong, then the saints will refer to the wrong verse. So we must be even accurate to this extent. Okay, let's have an exercise again. Okay, can everyone try? This one, I will not single y'all. Everyone try out by yourself in your heart. What is this? How will you translate it in your English? And how will you put the comma and the punctuation mark? 沙上是什么,知道吗? First Thessalonians. First Samuel, amen. First Samuel, chapter 8, verse 1 to chapter 10.
1 Sam 8, semicolon.
Semicolon? No, colon.
Colon 1.
Dash.
10. Colon 1.
And then the next one, is it comma or semicolon? To the punctuation mark from here to here. What's the punctuation mark for English?
Semicolon.
Yes, correct. Okay, but the person, no offense if you're the one, the person put it like that. So it's wrong, right? Am I right, saints? It's wrong. So whatever we do, even in comma, punctuation mark, semicolon, is so important. Now you all get it? Amen. Okay, next one. The second point is the memory verse must be from the Holy Bible Recovery Version. So some of us, when we do proofreading, we saw that they didn't use the Recovery Version. So take note, we should use the Recovery Version. Okay, the third point, we need to use British English. The ministry uses American English, but for Singapore, we use British English. So when we do the work, we need to convert it to ensure consistency. So these are some of the examples of the word that we need to change. Okay, fourth, we need to suggest words that the children can comprehend. So for example, over here, this is a Bible portion that mentions that 耶和华后悔造人在地上. So there's the Chinese word 后悔. So the Recovery Version used Jehovah repented. This is correct because this is really what the Bible used. But then, for the sake of the children, we may need to put a small next to the word repented, we say teachers may use the word regretted because the children may understand it better. Okay, because in the context of the children's mind, they may think repent means, oh, you did something wrong, I need to, you know, repent because I did something wrong. But God will never do wrong, right? Yeah, because the true meaning of repent is a change of mind. But the children may not understand, oh, repent is a change of mind. So we need to help the teachers out. Hey, teachers, when you're teaching, you can consider using the word regret. Yeah, so this is one example. Okay, so the fifth point, we can make use of grammar tools such as WordTune Editor or Grammarly. So after you translate, you can run through this so that when you submit, you will be more fluent. Okay, now I go to round two. Round two is proofreading. So when you receive the translation from round one, what's the first thing you need to do? You need to read first, read through the translation. Then, for example, I have this example. I have this round one translator say, oh, we also need to learn to receive all that God has prepared and rest in the Lord. This English-wise is okay. But they need to also remember, round two need to check against the Chinese text to make sure that it's accurate. So the Chinese text actually say, 我们也要学习享受. So it's not receive, right? Receive is 接受, 对吗? 享受 is enjoy. So in this round two, the proofreader need to change the word receive to enjoy. 就这样. Okay. So I have a proofreading example. Okay, so don't be offended if you're the one. Okay, we're all learning together, okay? So now first one, Isaac marrying Rebecca. Is it okay? It's quite okay, right? What's wrong with this? Should be double A. Okay. And then this one is double A also. Okay, so now I will flash out this one. So the proofreader feel that, instead of Isaac marrying Rebecca, maybe it sounds better, Rebecca's marriage to Isaac. So it does sound better. Okay. So they changed the spelling for Isaac, and then from around his age, he changed around the age. And then over here, Isaac became sad and lonely. English-wise, it's accurate, but when the person checked against the Chinese text, there's a Chinese word called 难免. So it means undoubtedly, Isaac became sad and lonely. So it's more accurate to that extent. And then after that, instead of the God of heaven and the God of earth, just script it to the God of heaven and earth. And then finally, the last one is the faithful old servant swore to him concerning this matter, but the Chinese text has the aspect of promising. So the proofreader add the word and promised. So this is round two, proofreading. Okay? So this is also another example of being more accurate in terms of, like over here, the translator translate as God's authority, but the Chinese text didn't say authority. The Chinese text say 美意. 美意 is not authority. So the proofreader changed to good intentions. Okay. Okay, now for Chinese, right? If you read the Chinese books, there's a lot of utterance in the Chinese sentences that is very, very long, very long. And somehow, when we translate, we tend to follow their punctuation marks also. 什么什么逗号, 什么什么逗号, 什么逗号. Then our translation also comma and comma and comma. So we can actually have the liberty to shorten the sentence by putting a full stop. So we don't need to follow exactly the punctuation mark of the Chinese text because it's a different thing. Yeah. Different grammar, amen. So over here is the same, like comma and God, and then comma, they were defeated, comma, many. So there's like one whole paragraph of commas, but for Chinese, we can break it up with a full stop. Okay, Okay, then another one is always refer to the Bible and follow the Bible utterance. So over here, there's this portion that say the chief ministers could not... Yeah, so there's this utterance that says, but they could not find any negligence or faults with him because he was faithful and without error. So this English-wise is okay, no problem. But what does the Bible say? The Bible uses words like, could find no ground for accusation of fault in as much as he was faithful and no negligence or fault was found related to him. So when we translate, we should also use the same utterance from the Bible. Yeah.
Can I know how many have like this? Because they're going to clear the food and the sisters here will pack for you.
How many big lunch?
1, 2. Now I move on to round three. Round three is the final round, and this is the most important round because whatever you do will be printed. Very easy. Yeah, any questions? Are you okay? It's okay if you cannot absorb everything because we will provide you the slides after that.
Do you know why round 1, 2, 3?
You have a question. The question is, why is there a need of round 1, round 2, and round 3?
Why?
Why is there a need? I think it's related to what we read just now.
Yeah. Why round 1, 2, 3? The more you read, the better it is. The more you revise, the better.
Amen.
Three groups of people doing three different rounds.
Amen. And this round is by the native speakers. Amen. So when we do at the last round, this one we also take note. We need to change it to the spelling of the numbers. And then another thing is make sure the reader understand what you want to relate. So for example, when you read that paragraph, you don't even understand, then how can you expect the one who buy the book to understand, right? So we need to do an exercise. Can I have one volunteer? One volunteer, please. Yeah, Titus, can you come up? Okay, we will have Brother Titus to be the teacher, okay? Pretend you are the teacher and they are the children.
Okay,
and then you are the teacher receiving this paragraph. Can you facilitate us in doing this activity with us? You stand at the side so they can also read. Yeah.
Oh man, what a
brother.
So I have to. Okay. Okay, everyone, can we sit in a circle? Then everyone sits.
Hey, we are really doing
it. Oh, really doing it?
Yeah. Maybe just the first row.
Okay, maybe just first.
Okay, just
maybe
first
just
row.
Just the brothers. How about that?
Oh, brothers. Okay, just the brothers.
Okay, children, can we sit in a circle?
Four brothers.
Okay, don't stand. Okay, you can stand up actually. Don't stand too close to each other. Okay, I'm going to give you a big ball.
Yeah.
Oh, there's actually. Oh, wow. Okay, don't be too close to us. Here's a big ball for you, and here's a small ball. Okay, this big ball signifies Esau, and this small ball signifies Jacob. Who does this signify?
Esau.
And?
Jacob.
Okay, good. Esau was very active. What is the next person? So, when you pass Esau, you don't pass it to the next person, but the next person. And he's very active. Jacob is gentle and quiet, so it just gets passed one time. So when you pass Esau, you pass twice. Jacob, you pass once. Okay, start to pass. Keep going, but not me. I'm facilitating. And stop. Now when the two balls meet, Jacob is caught by Esau. So whoever catches the two balls, you have to stand up and sing a hymn. Okay, so we try again. So it'll be passing it. Oh yeah, that's true, huh? Okay, then I'll join in. So this one passes, it skips one person. This one passes by one. Okay, and we're gonna go in opposite direction. So Jacob, you pass this way, Esau pass this way. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3, and pass. 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 So you have to try and catch someone. Pass. 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 Okay, so I managed to catch both, so then I have to stand up and sing a hymn together. I mean, I have to stand up and sing a hymn. Not together.
Yeah, not together.
Okay,
thank
all right.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Can I have the second volunteer? Second volunteer. Yeah, just one more volunteer. Sisters volunteer. One more. Okay, Ling Chi Lai. Pretend you're the teacher, but now you didn't receive this version, you received this version. Okay, repeat this to talk.
Do we play again?
you can play again. We have the time.
Wow, okay.
Okay.
So, the sisters?
Yeah. Can some sisters help? Clip it on. Maybe, Hui Min, Jinghua, and Christian, pretend she's a teacher and they are the children.
Okay, let us sit in a circle. Stand in a circle, sorry. Stand. And then you will hold a big one and you will hold a small ball. And, not closely seated to each other, sorry. And so because Esau is lively and active, so the big ball represents Esau and you're supposed to pass to the person next to you. So you have to skip one person. And then, and because Jacob is quiet and soft, so you shall pass the ball to the person next to you. And you can start passing in any direction.
Oh, you're not joining.
No. Okay, so because the two balls meet, it means that Jacob is overtaken by Esau. And why is it still together though?
Those who receive the two balls at the same time shall stand up.
And sing a hymn together. But it's supposed to be one person only, right?
So after you play a few rounds, you get a few.
I see. So in this case, the first round, it is Sister Xiao Zhou who got both balls at the same time. Then we'll play another few rounds. Then the other people who also got two balls at the same time?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
This one is for you.
Oh, I have already, sister. I bought already.
Give to someone else.
Okay. So the reason why I tell you this.
Sorry.
Okay, so the reason why I do this exercise is to show you, ensure the reader understand what you want to relate. So Titus, when you have this, can you, not so, right? How about Ling Qi? When you do this, are you confused?
Not so much.
Not so much. So that means at the bottom, we still need to edit more. That shows that we need a lot of, so this, actually, I'm done already. Yeah, so if possible, y'all consider before the Lord and participate in the translation service. Is there's one more testimony after me. But yeah, if you want to participate, yeah, it's really, it requires patience and endurance and perseverance. So just do this, and then if you sign up, means we're all together in this together. In the long run, until the book 12 is done. Amen. Hopefully, we can do this together. Ling Qi now has a testimony for all of us.
So I first started the children material translation work about 5 years ago, and I'm mainly doing the translating part and just started on the proofreading last year. And I really thank the Lord that we each have a portion and I'm able to function in this aspect. So it was a very special service that I always enjoy doing, and I personally learned translation and interpretation as a subject in school, but I realized that translating other texts is really very, very different from translating the ministry works. And hence, there is a need to rely on His wisdom and revelation. We cannot simply do this with our own wisdom. And there is a strong need for us to pray to the Lord before we start translating any of His words and teachings. Just like what was mentioned in the excerpts just now, when we are considering the right words and phrases, we should put down our pens and walk outside to call to the Lord or sing a few verses of hymns to relax our heart and increase the feeling in our spirit. Then when we return to the writing, we'll be able to express the things in a better way. And I also realized that when I translate the children material, I realized that I have there is a lack of constitution of His word in me, and hence there, in the process of translating, I'm given the opportunity to know more about some of the Bible stories and to understand the meaning and significance behind these stories. And that's how we can translate it in such a way that the English version will be able to achieve the same result as the Chinese version. And thus, we need to know the aim of the lessons well and ask the Lord to release the burden to us such that we can make sure we really cover the burden in the translated text as well. So may we have the Lord's presence as we translate and continue to labor in Christ.
You have a question? Any questions or any even sharing? Because I know some of y'all have been doing this also. Anything?
Maybe I just want to give a short testimony. I did the translation, I think a few years ago, but I can testify the portions I did really constituted into me. I can even remember until now. Praise the Lord.
In the original text, it will quote a certain number, but I don't have the hymnal. Just, I think one of example, it quoted 儿诗, what number, but I don't have the hymnal. 儿童诗歌本, so maybe, kind of, but I don't even have Chinese version either.
I know what you mean. It's okay. Question is actually not covered in my slides. Because every lesson, we have a children hymn. And the children hymn is actually published by Taiwan Gospel Book Room called 儿童诗歌. And in the book room downstairs, they sell the number to number English version. That means 儿童诗歌第一首, there is a book down, sold downstairs at level one. Hymn 1, and then they have the corresponding English. So those who did the translation who doesn't have this material, no problem, because at round 3, we will tidy up. Those because the, at round 3, there will be someone who have this book, and we can tidy up for y'all. Yeah.
So do you mean we skip the...
Yeah, you can skip that part called hymns, and then 儿童诗歌第一首. If you don't know what's the title in English or what, it's okay. You can leave it to the round 3. Because round 3, we will have someone who have that material.
Certain paragraph or sentence, I don't know how to translate. Can I just highlight it there and leave it to the next person? Or should I need to find it on the spot, like someone help me in this matter? Because it may be quite a few points I don't know how to translate. But sometimes there's quite actually a long passage to translate. I mean, like those parts, I'm not very certain how to do it.
So Sister Jinghua's question is, if in the process of translation, she's stuck and she doesn't know how to put it into English, right? Okay. That's, I mean, you can fellowship with the person who assigned you. Me. You can ask me. I will try to help. I can try to help. Yeah.
So the question is, like, let's say I have like 20 parts I need to consult you, so I have an appointment with you. Like.
Oh, I think if we are really in this team together, because now the way I do it is I always do one to one. Like I approach Jinghua, can you help to do lesson 2 to 3? I approach Davin, can you do lesson 4 to 5? It's very one to one. But if we are really in this team together, we can form a WhatsApp group, and then we can probably solve this together. And we can post in the WhatsApp group.